Hi, in the previous video mentioned using the robocopy command to speed up file copying. In this video we continue to use it to back up data like paid software. So how to do that? Let's do it with me in this video. My data is stored in a folder called data in the C partition of my computer. This data will be backed up to a folder called backup in the D partition of the computer. To backup that data, I create a batch file with the content as above. You update the source folder and the destination folder to suit you. In this video, the source folder is c2.data. The destination folder is d2/backup. After backing up the files, a log file is generated, which stores the results when backing up. You save the file with the extension bat. The file type is all files. To execute this batch file, you must open the file with administrative rights. Run as administrator. After a command window appears, the files will automatically back up from the source folder to the destination folder. You can check the result by opening the newly created log file. The log file tells you the backup time, the number of files, the speed. I will delete all the files in the backup folder to set up a backup schedule in the next step. Next, you put the backup.bat file in the c2.data/cmd folder. You write down the path to this batch file to set up the backup schedule. To schedule backups, you use the task scheduler available on Windows operating system. In the Windows search box, enter task scheduler. You open task scheduler and create a new task. Name the new task, I named it my backup. Backup jobs are done every day. Set the task execution time to 11 hours and 6 minutes, that is, after 2 minutes the backup job starts to execute. Start a program. You browse to the folder c2/data/cmd. Next, select the batch file backup.bat. Because the backup.bat file must be opened with administrative privileges, you set up the task you just created. You choose the task My Backup. Run with highest privileges. Configure for Windows 10. This configuration is suitable for both Windows 10 and Windows 11. So we have scheduled a successful backup. Let's wait until 11:06 to know the result. Currently the backup folder is empty. At exactly 11:06 a black command window appeared and the files were automatically backed up. At the end of the video, I will show you how to hide the black window, because it appears to be annoying for users. Open the log file and check the results. The result is the same as the previous backup, only it is done automatically. To make sure the data is safe, I will back it up over the network. You can back up to another computer or NAS devices. You just need to add a new command to your existing batch file and you can back up data over the network. You use Notepad to edit the backup.bat file. You copy and paste the command as above. You update the source folder and the destination folder to suit you. the root directory is unchanged. C2.data. Here I will back up to another computer with IP address 10.11.32.14. The destination directory is /IP address/destination directory name. /10.11.32.14/backup. After adding the above command, don't forget to save your changes and close the file. Next, we change the backup execution time to check the results. It's 11:08 a.m., so I'll set the time to 11:09 a.m. and save the changes. Let's wait another minute to see if the data is backed up to the shared folder. At 11:09 a.m. a command window appears, the files are backed up to the destination folder one by one. Because the backup is over the network, the backup speed will be slower than backing up between hard drives on the same computer. So the data has been backed up in two different places. One is another hard drive on the same computer, another is another computer with a shared folder over the network. In this part, I will show you how to hide the command window when backing up data. You create a new VBScripts file with the content as above. You then update the path to the batch file that works for you. In this case, the path is c2.data/cmd/backup.bat. You then put this file in the same directory as the backup.bat file. You save the file with the extension VBS. The file type is all files. Next, you edit the task in the task scheduler. Open task scheduler. You choose my backup. Next, you replace the file backup.bat with the file backup.vbs. Then set the time. Set the time to 11:14 a.m. Save the changes and close the task scheduler. I will create a new text file to check if everything works fine. A plain text file. Let's wait and see if it works. At 11:14 a.m. a new text file appeared in the backup folder. And an even better thing is that the black command window does not appear. That's good work. Next, I check the shared folder over the network. So your data will be automatically backed up in two different places. Subsequent backups will be faster because it only updates the changes. This way you can create your own backup tool like paid software. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.